Keith, I know you're not a China trade expert. Don't worry, I'm not going to pin you down on that headline. But the fact that we saw futures double on one headline using a lot of modifiers like may and maybe partial, things like that, just how sensitive is this market still 2 years later to trade?
Oh, it's very sensitive. In fact, we overlaid tweets on tariffs with the market in the third quarter, and the peaks and troughs have coincided with these tweets. But I will also tell you, I think this tells you, you know, how depressed expectations are right now, because no one's expecting a full deal. If we just get a little bit of progress, that's enough for the market. And we like to say often that, you know, when expectations are low, a little bit of good news goes a long way. And Brian, I'll tell you right now, the one thing that keeps us more on the positive side for this market is investors' position is still pretty light, meaning we've seen the most outflows from equity mutual funds over the last 12 months that we've seen in over 20 years. Hedge funds exposure to the market is still relatively low. And just last week, we had an update on the retail investor, and the amount of bulls on the market is only at 21%. That's almost where it was back last December after that sell-off.
Since so few people now expect a straight deal, Keith, is maybe a non-escalation sort of the new deal, if you will? I mean, if the dog stops biting but still growls, is that the new good news?
Yeah, it's good enough is the way I would characterize this. And I'd also say, you know, the main thing from a market perspective, there's been concerns about recession. If we don't have an escalation, our base case for the U.S. economy is we continue to grind higher. And just looking at the statistics, when you're outside of a recession, about 85% of the time, the market is up on a one-year basis. I also think, Brian, people are just very nervous in the fourth quarter, which is typically supposed to be a good time for the market, but they have a recency bias of what happened last year when we had that dramatic sell-off. But I'll tell you, there's a lot of things that are different this year from last year.
Yo, quickly, do you think that the markets will end the year higher than they are right now, Keith?
Yeah, I mean, yes, I would say just going by the stats, 80% of the time the market is higher when you've had a big move into the fourth quarter. So our base case would be that. But more likely, we're looking more 12 months forward, and we still are on the positive side of the market at this point.
All right, Keith Lerner, SunTrust Advisory Services. Relatively optimistic, Keith. We appreciate you rolling with the headlines. Thank you very much. See you soon.